Without charge and without trial, and for no particular reason, I'm breaking the law, and a good thing too. But when the government does this wholesale to thousands of men, women and children, lock them up without charge, without trial, for year upon year upon year, they have the temerity to call it this weird thing called an immigration policy. Well, I don't know what part of an immigration policy requires people to be locked up and the key just about chucked away. I don't know what part of an immigration policy requires people to be shot with tear gas, shot with 12-gauge shotgun rounds in Christmas Island this week, and isn't that a wonderful euphemism? A 12-gauge shotgun round is now called a beanbag bullet. Isn't that lovely? A beanbag bullet, because they cover it with cloth. Every time you talk like this, you get people, you know, there's one or two in every crowd, you get someone coming up and saying, well, surely, you know, we can't just let people in, you know, really. We don't know who these people are. You know, maybe they're out to do us some no good or something. And at times like that, I point out, well, yes, a lot of people come into the country, we have no idea really who they are. The last time I checked, the people that flew the planes into the buildings on the 9th, on the 11th of September 2001 were all travelling first class and all had valid visas. So how's this for a proposition? Let's keep ourselves nice and safe and secure by locking up without charge or trial every single person who comes in flying first class on a valid visa. Now, if you propose that, like, you know, people think you're a little bit strange. People think that, you know, you're a bit peculiar. But it makes more logical sense than what the government's doing. But what the government's doing isn't about logic. It's not about people's logic. It's not about human logic. There's a sort of sick political logic to what they're doing. There is no reason why you have to have these detention centres. Malcolm Fraser's government, Malcolm Fraser, for Christ's sake, you know, the arch-robbing scumbag of the 1970s, he managed to have a government that locked up pretty much no one that came to this country on a boat. But for some reason now, we're told that, you know, the country will go to rack and ruin. It won't. The political logic behind mandatory detention is to whip up racism. That's why Howard strengthened the regime, and that's why Labor keeps it. And it's a very useful regime because it sends a signal to every single one of us that there's something wrong with these people. That there's some reason to fear these people, and that there must be some really good reason why they're all locked up under lock and key and tear gassed and shot. There is no good reason apart from their sick logic of promoting racism. Just one other thing I wanted to talk about, I suppose, is the importance of refugee resistance and the importance of standing in solidarity with it. Because if the government takes upon itself the right to lock people up without charge or trial, that creates a very serious situation for everyone's democratic rights. I'm not a refugee and hopefully I never will be, but the fact that the government lowers the bar so much and says there are particular classes of people that have zero rights, that have no rights whatsoever in Australia, makes it that much easier for the government to attack everyone else's rights. One example close to me is in the construction industry where I work, where the Australian Building and Construction Commission has extraordinary powers to compel people to answer questions, to lock people up without charge or trial, and so on and so forth. It's much easier for that sort of stuff to happen when the government is busy locking up refugees. So I think it's really important, not just because we're decent human beings, I think it's really important for all of our rights to stand with the refugees. About a decade ago, you know, there was a major public issue around refugees. And it took a lot, it took a hell of a lot to get even the small changes that we won to the refugee policy of the Howard government. We never changed their formal written policy, but by God, we got a hell of a lot of people out of detention that otherwise would have maybe still be under lock and key. But that took a lot. It took a lot of refugee resistance. It took a lot of marching. It took a lot of hunger strikes. It took a lot of refugees actually, you know, resorting to really desperate measures, such as, you know, setting fire to these concentration camps. It took all of that, and it took thousands and thousands of people marching until we were footsore, doing all sorts of things, from rural Australians to refugees through to the more militant actions. All of that was crucial to winning just the small changes that we won during the Howard years. This isn't the biggest gathering of all time today, but it is really important that every time, I think today it's fantastic, that it's really important that every time the refugees take a stand inside, they can see that there are at least a few people and hopefully a growing number of people that will take a stand alongside them outside, for their sake and for ours. Thank you.